All right, guys. This will be my second box break that I've done here. I'm trying to do some of the unusual stuff that people don't usually see very often. This is 1986 Topps Tattoos. It does say 18 baseball tattoos, but that's per pack. There's actually 36 packs, and I'll show you here in a second what they mean by 18 tattoos. These are pretty generic looking. I'm going to try to learn from my mistakes from the first video. I did open a pack of these already to kind of save some time, so I already knew in advance what to expect out of some of these. The wax packs weren't sealed very hard, as the 1986 Fleer Star stickers weren't sealed very bad, so they were relatively easy to get out of the packs. Now, when I first opened this pack, the piece of gum was on here, and you can see what kind of an impression it made. Not very pretty. There's still some crystallization from the sugars because it's been sitting in there for 24 years. And it actually soaked through somewhat to, at least the four corners did, because of the pressure from being boxes stacked on top of boxes inside of cases on cases. But it actually ruined two of those. In my opinion, it ruined two sections right here. So those won't be any good for anything. But you can see how generic these pictures are. And these are actually numbered. 2 out of 24. You can see, I'm not sure how focused that is, but you can see, I'm telling you right now, it says 2 out of 24 sheets. This stuff is all reversed because these are tattoos. They're intended on being put on, and then when you get it off of there, it ends up, basically it's just ink, and it puts an imprint like a stamp on your skin when you were kids. 18 stickers, they mean 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 14, 15, 16. So I guess I'm not sure. Oh, I might have. 2, 4, 5, 6, 7. 3, 6, 9. 7 and 9 is 16, so I don't know what they mean by 18. I didn't tear anything off of here. You got me. I'm a little surprised by that one. Should have done my homework a little better on that one, instead of looking like an idiot on the video here, but that's part of the learning experience. I mean, there's a lot of stuff here that I don't know about these. I'm learning at the same time you guys are. I read up on these. Like I said, it's 2 out of 24 sheets. There's 24 different sheets like this. Of course, some people like the sheets to be intact, but with the main theory of my BenhamBaseballCards.com, the main theory is to sell things as singles, so I actually may end up, depending on how many sheets I get of different ones, and with all the damaged ones on here, nobody's going to want to buy this in the condition it's in. So again, the only way somebody was going to be able to beat something like this gum stain was to get them opened in 1986, and that way the gum didn't sit there very long, and I have no idea how long you could have waited until the gum stains would have set in. It may have been instant right in 86, so I'm guessing these aren't too popular. They don't have a very high price ranking in the price guides. I'll probably end up separating these because I'm thoroughly based on singles. I mean, a Brian Fisher fan might want this Brian Fisher card, but doesn't want to pay for this whole thing, and doesn't want to actually have to deal with it and have to tear it themselves. They'd rather have somebody else do it, and I'm going to actually take a lot of time to separate all these things carefully. I'm going to make sure it gets done right, and I'm ordering a guillotine cutter. And if that doesn't work, I have a razor blade, and a razor blade is going to make the thinnest cut possible, and it's going to be very super detailed. It's not just going to be I'm not just going to slide the razor on it and call it a day. I'm going to actually make sure that the lines are lined up. There's a little bit of an indentation where they perforated these, so I'm going to make sure razor lines are lined up on there and that the cuts are as straight as possible. Again, they're not going to go for very high prices, being that they're not a real popular set. Opeachy also, this is the Topps version. Opeachy actually made a version of this set as well, so keep your eyes open. It says in the price guide that they're valued, the value is the same, but I'm not sure how much truth there is to that. The value is basically what somebody's willing to pay for it. Doesn't really have anything to do with what price guide companies think. Here's a pack that I haven't opened yet. You can see the, get the gum dust off of here, the gum, the sugar dust. Let's see how soaked through this one got. Ooh, that ain't good. That went through. It didn't go through as bad on this one as it did on the first one. But you can see that, obviously, the Jim Presley and the two generic stickers here aren't very good. And the DeSensei's and the Tudor are going to be tough sells with marks on them like that. But the rest of them look to be pretty good. Nobody stands out, really, in the conditioning. But again, I'm really not sure where they get the 18 tattoos from if there's only 16 in each pack. 2, 4, 5. So you're all with me here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So I'm not sure where the 18 tattoos, because it even says on the pack here. Here's what a 24-year-old piece of gum looks like. Mmm, delicious. Anybody want to chew that? That is nasty. It actually doesn't smell that great either, but it doesn't hurt the cards at all. Or the stamp. In this situation, the tattoos. But if you put it up close to your nose, it doesn't smell fresh. Is what I mean by that. I wouldn't be chewing it anytime soon. Well, there's that one. See what another one of these has. I'm at 6.5 minutes right now, so hopefully I can do a lot better with this video and not have to go over. Take note of the color changing on the gum. Yummy. Oh, thanks. I should be working on those packs and stuff later instead of wasting my video time. I failed to mention in the first video, and I forgot to do it in this video as well, that the first thing I should have mentioned was that this box did not come cellophaned. It did not come with any kind of a plastic seal wrapper on it, indicating its factory sealedness and non-tamperedness. But this one, again, is not as bad as the first one, but it's a little worse than the second one. So, but obviously that section right there is trashed. Thank goodness it's Mark Salas and two generic stickers. Got us a Reggie Jackson here that I lost with some stains. Terry Pendleton, Mike Marshall, Kent Hervick, Tim Raines down here at the bottom. 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Again with the 16. Still pretty lost on that. It's quite baffling to me. If anybody has the answer to that mystery, I wouldn't mind knowing what the story is behind that. But that's about it, just to wrap this video up. I'm at 8 minutes already, so I don't have to spend 5 or 6 hours editing like I did on that first video. 36 packs in the box, 16 stamps or 16 tattoos in each pack. I don't little baffled by the 18 baseball tattoos thing there. But that's what you get in the pack. That's what you get in the box, guys. It's just a rough overview. There is gum in them, so you're gonna end up losing some quality from the sections that get stained. I'll try to get this video edited a little faster. I think I'm almost ready. The 86 Clear Star stickers box has got 15 and almost 16 minutes left on it. Uploading to YouTube now, and this one's going to follow it right up on there. Appreciate you guys watching.